What is up, everybody? So today I'm gonna be opening and doing a review on the angled multi-grip bar. So I just ordered this bar, and I wanna go ahead and preface this with Titan Fitness gets a lot of bad reviews because of the quality of the boxes or the way they ship their products. Titan Fitness has free shipping, and they offer some decent quality equipment for pretty cheap. So if you're on a budget, I highly recommend them. I personally haven't really had any bad issues. They have messed up the shipment on one of the bars, but I mean, you're paying half of the price for a bar that, you know, some of the bigger names like Rogue or Sorinex or Elite FTS make, and it's free shipping as well. I will say that I'm extremely satisfied because this bar, I actually have been wanting to order for quite a while, but it kept saying back order, back order, back order. And I was checking multiple websites to see if maybe there's a website that would pop up like Vulcan or Rep or anybody who would have this kind of bar, but at a sooner date. And so this bar actually wasn't even supposed to be shipped until I believe August 4th. It's July 13th right now, and I ordered this a week and 2 days ago. So they were way ahead of schedule, which as a customer, I'm extremely satisfied because I wasn't even expecting this until August. So I'm super excited and pumped to go ahead and start using this. I'm gonna go ahead and open it. I'll show you guys the bar. Let me see. And as you can see, yeah, there is some minor damage. I mean, it's not that bad. Like, you really can't. I think the biggest issue would be this right here. And it's like, you can't even really see the bar from that little hole, that one right there. But I mean, the box is extremely put together. It's not messed up. See, is it showtime? Oh yeah! All right. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited for this bar. All right, here it is. Oh! I almost put a hole in the ceiling right there. Yeah, never open your boxes in your garage gym if you have 9-foot ceilings. That was a terrible idea. I'm glad I actually didn't put a hole in that. All right. There you go. And for the big reveal, even though you can already see the bar, go ahead and pop this in slow motion. Man, oh my gosh, this bar, oh man, this is probably, I'm going to be completely honest with you guys, I'm extremely, just from first look, satisfied with this purchase. So I believe I paid $125 after taxes. I think it's $114, and then the taxes got it up to $125 and free shipping. Man. So I'm not necessarily sure in terms of, you know, like the vocabulary of it, but it looks kind of glossy. It's not like a typical matte. And you can see like their logos are starting to peel on that. So they just put like a little sticker on there. So I'll probably peel that off since it's already coming off. That's probably the only issue that I see with this bar. And as you can see, I'm gonna run an overlook of this, showing you guys what I'm talking about here. But this knurling is pretty good. I don't see any kind of mess ups in the knurling. Man, so this bar is super awesome. I'm going to be using it to bench press with on Wednesday. It's super cool. So it's got four different grips, and I believe they're angled at 30 degrees. So this helps put you in the right position for bench press. So like a lot of people have issues with their elbows flaring out. With this bar, you can't flare out your elbows. So it helps reinforce proper position and movement mechanics for the bench press. I'm personally using it. I don't necessarily have an issue with that, but I'm personally using it to add in another variation of the bench press. And this also makes the bench press a little more tricep dominant, which is perfect because that is one of the key factors to increasing your bench press. Man, this is fantastic. Honestly, I think this is the best product that I've ever ordered from Titan Fitness. So what I'm gonna do is I'm holding on to this part of the video, and I will, yeah, that logo is coming off on both sides. It's on that side and that side. So I'll probably just go ahead and take that off since it's a sticker. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold on to this part of the video, and I'm bench pressing on Wednesday. I'm gonna record my bench press session, and I will let you guys know what I actually truly think about the bar. I mean, obviously looks don't mean everything. They mean quite a bit, but I wanna see the functionality of it. I wanna make sure that this grip is pretty good. That knurling's good. It's not necessarily like shark tooth knurling, but this is fantastic. You know, a lot of, there's a brand, I don't wanna say what brand it is, but there's a brand of this bar that I have at my gym, and they have no knurling on these handles. And I'm just like, it's awful because even with chalk, I feel like the bar is gonna be slipping out of my hands. And I honestly don't know why anybody would make a bench press bar without knurling. If you guys know, go ahead and drop it in the comments, but I would rather have knurling on my bar that I'm holding over my face than not have knurling, you know? So what I'm gonna do is, like I said, I'm gonna be holding on to this part of the video. It's Monday, July 13th. Wednesday, July 15th, I will be bench pressing with this bad boy. I'll upload a video of me actually lifting with it and then give you guys my final thoughts on the piece. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this unveiling. I'll go ahead and slide you on over to Wednesday. So that is my first workout with the angled multi-grip bar from Titan Fitness. So just from this first experience, there are some things that I want to address about the bar. And I also posted a picture of the bar on the Garage Gym Community Facebook page, and I had a couple of questions on there, so I'd like to address those on here as well. First thing, so this bar actually weighs 48 pounds. So if you're used to lifting with a 45 pound bar, then you know it's 3 pounds, but I would definitely account for that, especially if you're going for a PR. Another thing is that if you have a horizontal wall mount, so something like, let me see if y'all can see that, something like one of those where the bars just run left to right, if you have one of those, this might not fit on there depending on how big of a gap that you have on that wall mount. Another thing is that it might take up 2 storage spots. It's got, obviously from here you can tell, it's not just straight across like a regular bar. So this added dimension here will cause you to take up 2 storage spots whenever you put that up on the wall. Another question was, how much space is there between the grips and then the grip and the end length? So as you can see here, when you grab the bar from any of these first 3 angled grips, you'll have quite a bit of space between your hand and the next grip.
there is no issue when you, you know, put your hands in there and grab. You're not going to hit the one right next to it. Even on the far end, there is a smaller gap between that angled grip and this edge. But I grab that with absolutely no problem at all. I'm not even really thinking about touching that end piece whenever I reach in and grab that grip. So those were three of the main questions that I got on the Facebook page. Now, one of the biggest issues that I have with this bar, and it kind of annoyed me a little bit during today's workout, is that this bar, the inside width of this bar, is not compatible with my Sorenex 3x3 rack. Now, the depth, so I measured the depth, or actually it's width, from here to this end over here, and it's 40.5 inches, right? And then this is going to be 40 1/4. Now, Titan Fitness, they claim that their racks are all 42 inches in width. I owned the X3 prior to the Sorenex rack, and I know from squatting in it that this rack is definitely a little bit wider than the X3, but online it says that the X3 is 42 inches width from inside to inside right here. So if they're claiming that, I don't know if they made any adjustments or maybe they changed the cross member that's right here, but it definitely wasn't like that when I had it 2 years ago. Now, why is this important? This bar does not fit on my standard J-cups. And I put the J-cups right here just so you can see. So right here, it'll fit really tight into this J-cup. However, and I'm gonna put a little overview, a little over video of me moving this here so you can see, but the bar does not move from this position, right? So you can move it either way and it's not gonna move, right? So you couldn't even unrack this if you wanted to, just because you won't be able to get your hands set, right? So that's a little annoying. However, I mean, I have these model lift attachments. I don't like using them for many other things other than squat, just because I do have to unbolt them and bolt them every time I wanna use them. However, I was able to bench press with this bar coming out of here. It was a very tight squeeze. There's probably a quarter of an inch on each side right here. So if I did come up, like maybe I wasn't centered and I came up and racked it more to one side, I would definitely hit the J-cup with this bar, which is a safety issue. And if you actually pay attention to my last bench press video, which is four plates, which is 408 pounds with this bar, you can see that the bar, when it came down, hit the safety strap and kind of like shifted me over a little bit. It was kind of annoying. I was still able to get the weight, but that's definitely something you have to take into account for, especially if you're lifting by yourself. You don't want, you know, the bar to hit your safety pins or straps and then throw you off. So that's kind of one of the biggest complaints I have about the bar. It is actually like a real issue. If I didn't have these monolift attachments, I wouldn't have been able to bench with it today. However, I will say it's an issue, it's a complaint, but I'm not going to return the bar. I probably won't even make a fuss about it because the bar is, like I said, it's $115, right? $125 with taxes. It's a lot cheaper than the Rogue and like Elite FTS and any of those other companies. I believe Vulcan and Rep have one as well, but it's a lot cheaper than those companies, and it also has the knurled grips. Like I said earlier on in the video, the knurled grips are a huge component to why I purchased this bar. I've lifted with a bar that doesn't have knurling on it, and it hurts so bad, and it always feels as if it's going to slip right out of my hand. And with the weight that I'm putting up, I'm extremely concerned with, you know, all the safety measures around lifting, So I'm not going to risk an injury with dropping the bar on myself just because I want to bench with, you know, another company that maybe fits a little better. So yeah, so I'm not even going to really, you know, fuss about it too much, but definitely do take it into consideration whenever you purchase this bar. Like I said, just measure the inside width. If your rack's a little bit wider, then I would definitely go for it. It's a great bar. And what I'll do is I'll go ahead and put the link to this bar down in the description just in case you do want to purchase it. And then actually, if there's anyone out there that has a Titan Fitness, you know, T2, T3, X2, X3, any of those power racks, and you have one of these bars, please do drop a comment and let me know if you have any issues with this bar inside of your rack. I'm very curious to know if this bar actually is compatible with those racks, just because that's a very important factor and that people should take into consideration whenever purchasing, you know, equipment. But other than that, that's a wrap. If you guys have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments. And if you like the video, go ahead and smash the like button and subscribe to my channel for more content. I've got a series that I put out, Bench Press More Weight. It's a 4-part series, so if you're interested on bench pressing more weight, which I'm sure everybody is, go ahead and check out that video. I'll go ahead and put the links right here, so that way you can click over and check those out as well. Until next time, stay strong.